Welcome to the session on the subject Design of Machine Elements 2, the subject code 18ME62 of VTU. That is the module number 2, Design of Spur and Helical Gears. So in the last two sessions, we discussed on the numerical. So I will continue the same thing in this session. Coming to the next problem, so in case of spur gears, so in a spur gear arrangement, a pinion made up of cast steel is rotating at 900 rpm and driving a cast iron gear at 150 rpm. The teeth are to have 20 degree stub involute profile and the maximum power to be transmitted is 25 kW. Determine the module and face width, check the dynamic and wear load also. The pinion has 16 teeth with the surface hardness of 250 Brinell hardness number BHN. Take the static stress for the pinion as 103 MPa and for gear as 55 MPa. Assume E suffix P is equal to 96 GN per meter square and E suffix G is equal to 207 GN per meter square. So in this problem, we have been given the RPM of the pinion and the gear, and the type of tooth profile is 20 degree stub tooth profile. So it is given here, and the maximum power to be transmitted is given as 25 kW. Then we need to design the gears for the dynamic and wear load. Given the number of teeth on the pinion as 16, as well as the BHN on the pinion is given as 250, and the values of stress for the pinion and the gears are given as 103 MPa and 55 MPa respectively, as well as the Young's modulus for the pinion. This EP refers to the pinion, is given as 96 GN per meter square, and Young's modulus for the gear is given as 207 GN per meter square. Coming to the solution part, now the velocity ratio is given by the equation N1 over N2 is equal to D2 over D1 is equal to Z2 over Z1. So since the value of RPM for both are known, so you can find out the velocity ratio. It will be 900 over 150. That is the velocity ratio will be 6. Now Z2 is I into Z1. So therefore, if you substitute the number of teeth that is given in the problem for Z1, that is 16, we are going to get the number of teeth on the gear as 96. Next, the first step would be to find the weaker member between the two. For that, we need to find out the Lewis form factor, because the stress values are different, the materials are different. So therefore, the Lewis form factor for the 20 degree stub tooth profile is given from the design data handbook, equation number 12.5E, page number 204. We have y is equal to 0.175 minus 0.95 over z, where z is the number of teeth. Now, for the Lewis form factor for the pinion is given by 0.175 minus 0.95 over Z1. So if you substitute the value for Z1, so we are going to get Y1 as 0.1156. And also the Lewis form factor for the gear is given by 0.175 minus 0.95 over Z2. So let us substitute the value of Z2. We are going to get the value of Y2 for the gear as 0.1651. So now the strength factor for the pinion and gear need to be found out. So strength factor for the pinion is given by sigma d1 into y1. So that is 103 for this value of the stress or allowable static stress for the pinion, that is 103 MPa into y1 0.1156, we are going to get 11.90 for the as the strength factor. And then strength factor for the gear is given by sigma d2 into y2. So if you see the allowable static stress given for the gear is 55 MPa. So if you multiply this with y2 0.1651, we are going to get the value as 9.08. So therefore, from this we can see that the strength factor for this gear is lesser in compared to the pinion. Therefore, the gear is the weaker member and design is to be based on the gear. Next, let us go for the next step, that is to find out the module. So here I would like to go for the second method, that is using the torque. So the Lewis beam strength is given by the equation number 12.5b as m is equal to 2mt over sigma d cv into k into capital Y into z whole to the power 1/3. So this equation we can write it as m cube into cv, that is equal to 2 into mt divided by sigma d into k into y into z. So here we have this particular, this is not there, sigma d into k into y into z. So next, let's substitute for capital Y is given by the form factor is given by the product y into small y. So therefore, you can write this as m cube into cv is equal to 2mt divided by sigma d into k into pi into y into z. This is the equation what we have in terms of the relation between the torque and the module. Then the value, the equation for the torque we have given by 9.5 × 10⁶ into p divided by n. So here let's multiply this with the service factor. Either we have to multiply it with the Ft, that is the tangential load, or to the torque. So here we are going to multiply this to the torque. So here we have taken N2 because the design is based on the gear. So therefore taken the it for the gear. So next, since the service condition is not mentioned or not given, let us take for the medium shock conditions with the 8 to 10 hours service per day from table number 12.8, the value of CS is 1.5. So therefore, if you substitute in the previous equation for the torque, that is 9.55 × 10⁶ into power is 25. So let's just substitute 25 in terms of kilowatt into CS is 1.5, which we have taken from the table, the service conditions assuming medium shock conditions with 8 to 10 hours working per day. Now N2 is 150 rpm. So therefore we are going to get the value of torque as 2387.5 into 10 to the power 3 newton millimeters. So now we have the equation for K given by B divided by M, where phase width ranges from in terms of m 9.5 m to 12.5 m. so therefore we can take this as k as 10, as this falls between this range. So next, let us substitute all these values in the equation for m cube cv. So we have the value of the torque, that is 2387.5 × 10³ Nm, and here when coming to the denominator, sigma d is nothing but sigma d2, since the design is based on gear, that is 55 MPa or Newton per mm square, into k is 10, because it is given by the ratio b by m, so which we have taken it as 10. Then into capital Y is denoted by pi into small y, where small y is small y2, since the design is based on the gear. And finally, z is z2, that is teeth on the gear, since the design is based on the gear. So therefore we get m cube cv value as 174.35, which is the required value. So next, here let us assume the value of cv as 0.5, so that we can find out the value of the actual module m. So therefore here, if we substitute 0.5 in this equation, we are going to get m cube into 0.5 is equal to 174.35, or else m is nothing but 7.038 millimeters. So if we refer to the standard module table, that is table number 12.2, so we have the module number 8 mm, the next value. So let's take it as a module as 8 mm. So for this, if we go for the value of the D1 and D2, we are going to get it as m into Z1, that is 8 into 16, that is 128 mm, and D2 as m into Z2, that is 8 into 96, that will be 768 mm. Since the value of CV was assumed, we need to check for this CV. So that is, the velocity is given by pi d2 n2 over 16 to 10 power 3. So since the design is based on the gear, so therefore substituting the values of the d2 and n2, we are going to get the velocity as 6.032 meter per second. So since v is less than 8 meter per second, we have the equation CV 3.05 over 3.05 plus v. So that will be, if you substitute the value of this v, you're going to get the value of CV as 0.3358. This is the value of the CV that we are going to get. Now next, we need to check for this. So m cube CV, if we substitute what value of the module what we have taken is 8 cube into this value of CV, so that is 0.3358 should be there here. Now if we substitute for this, we are going to get the m cube CV new value as 171.92, but this value is lesser than whatever the value of m cube CV which is required. So therefore we need to go for the next trial. So the design is not safe, hence we need to adopt the next value of the module from the table number 12.2. So next value what we have from the table is module number m is equal to 10 mm. So if we refer to the standard table 12.2, now here the diameters, pitch circle diameters for pinion and gear, as the module changes here, so m into z1, that will be 10 into 16, that will be 160 millimeters it should be, and D2 is m into z2, that is 10 into 96, that will be 960 millimeters. Next, if you go for the velocity, since the values of d has changed, so we have to find out the velocity, that is pi d2 into 60 to 10 power 3, that will be pi into 960 into n2 is 150 rpm, so divided by 16 to 10 power 3, that we are going to get 7.54 meter per second as the velocity. So now again, velocity is less than 8 meter per second, so using the same equation, we are going to get the value of the CV. If we substitute the value of this velocity here, we are going to get, so if we substitute the value of this CV here, we are going to get m cube, that is 10 to the power 3 into the value of CV what we obtained is 0.288 for the in the previous step. So that is, we are going to get the value of m cube CV new as 288. So therefore the value of this new value m cube CV is now greater than the required value. So therefore we can go ahead with this, the design will be safe and we can adopt this value of the module. So let's take this value of the module, that is standard module, as 10 millimeters. So once we find this, now k is taken as b by m, or b is k times m, so k is taken as 10 times m, so k is taken as 10, so therefore it is faced with b is 10 times the module, that is 10 into 10, that will be 100 millimeters. And also the pitch circle diameter of the pinion, d1 is equal to m into z1, it will be 10 into 16 is the number of teeth, so that is 160 mm, and pitch circle diameter of the gear is d2 is equal to m into z2, it will be 10 into z is 96 teeth, so therefore 960 mm is what we are going to get. Next, we need to find out the value of the FT, that is the tangential tooth load. So it is given by 2MT over D2. So if you substitute the values of MT and the physical diameter of the gear, we are going to obtain the value of this FT as 4973.96 newtons. Next step is to find out the dynamic load. We have the equation from equation number 12.12. So FD is equal to FT plus K3V into CV plus FT over K3V plus square root of CV plus FT. So here we need to find out the value of the dynamic factor. So for that, first of all, we need to refer to the table number 12.14. So for the velocity 8 meter per second, we have the maximum permissible error from that table as 0.05 millimeters. So therefore, since in this problem the Young's modulus is specified, so we can directly go for the equation to find out the dynamic factor. Capital C is equal to E divided by small e, that is the error, divided by K1 into 1 by E1 plus E2. This is the equation what we have. So where K1 is a constant which depends upon the form of the tooth. Since here the form of the tooth is 20 degrees term, so it is 8.70. So if we substitute all these values, the value of the error, the constant and the Young's modulus for the pinion and gear respectively, we are going to obtain the value of C as 376.92 newtons per millimeters. So now we need to substitute all these in the equation for FD or dynamic load. Substituting all these things as well as the velocity, that is 7.54 meter per second precisely, and then the values of the K3 in SI units, that is 20.67, and as well as the value of the FD. So therefore we are going to obtain the value of FD, that is dynamic load, as 23,323.90 newtons, or this is nothing but 23.32 kilonewtons. Next step is to find out the wear load. So we have the equation for wear load FW given by D1 BQK equation number 12.15A. So where K is nothing but the load stress factor, which is given by, in terms of the Young's modulus, it is given by this equation, sigma A square into sine alpha over 1.4 into 1 by E1 plus 1 by E2. So if we are using this equation, since the Young's modulus is given in this problem, so therefore where alpha is nothing but the pressure angle and sigma A is nothing but the surface endurance limit of the material. So now from referring to the table number 12.16, so for the given combination of the materials, that is steel pinion and cast iron gear, so if you refer to the table, we are going to obtain the value of the endurance limit as 617.8 MPa. This is the value of the endurance limit that we get from the table. Next, let us substitute all these things in the above equation here. So if you substitute this alpha, that is the pressure angle, is 20 degrees sharp, so 20 degree 20, so E1 and E2 are given, so let's substitute all these values. We are going to get the value of K, load stress factor, as 1.421. Next, we need to find the ratio factor, that is given by 2d2 by d2 plus d1, or 2z2 by z2 plus z1. So if we substitute the values of z2 and z1, we are going to get it as 1.714. And now let's substitute all these things, since we have obtained the k value as well. So let's substitute all these things. Fw is equal to d1 bqk. D1 is 160 mm, the physical diameter of the pinion. B is face width 100 mm. Q is 1.714 here and K is 1.421. So we are going to obtain the value of FWS 38,969.50 meter. So this is satisfactory since so the value of this FW, that is the wear load, is greater than the dynamic load, the design is satisfactory. So this completes the solution.